All right, so today I have a fun challenge. We're gonna take the Honda and the Infiniti and do an MPG off. Now, I know what you're thinking, obviously. How's this 90s luxury car with a V8 and 220,000 miles possibly going to compete with this Honda? And I thought of that. So, let me give you an example here. Back in the day, Top Gear did a challenge where they raced a Prius against an M3. The Prius would be driven as hard as it could, while the M3 would be driven at the same pace behind it. And the M3 eventually ended up winning that challenge. And I thought it'd be cool to try and replicate that, but with everyday driving. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take the Honda and drive it as inefficiently as possible. You know, dropping a gear, staying in lower gears than I need to, windows down, AC up through the middle of Lexington, like through downtown, and through, well, just no interstate driving, really. Just all as slow as I can be. While the Infiniti would be driven on the interstate, windows up, no AC, and just driving as smoothly and as fuel efficiently as I can in it. I think it's going to be an interesting challenge to see what happens. I honestly don't know what to expect. And if the Honda ends up destroying it like I think it could do, then it'll be interesting to see how much it destroys it by. But if it's close, then it'll be even more interesting. So, again, just to recap, this will be driven as hard as possible, pretty much. Windows down, AC up, no fuel efficiency in mind. While the Infiniti will be driven as fuel efficiently as possible. Windows up, AC off, and this will be going downtown and through any slower routes that I see that is still a direct route. And this will go on the interstate where it can just cruise. So, without further ado, let's hop in the Honda and get to the starting spot. Okay, so here's the start to our challenge. We got a gas station here, and I'm going to drive across Lexington with this car, as you know, gonna be as nonchalant as I can about fuel economy and stuff. I apologize about the wind, it's very windy here. Gonna be as nonchalant about fuel economy as I can, basically just taking the most inefficient route to the other side of Lexington and then back here. So, let's get into it. Alright, so I have made my drive and changed my mind. We're not actually going to be going back to, we're just going to be going from one side to the other side, and that's it. So, we've made it here to this other gas station. It's not the same one. I know it's the same kind, but it's not the same one. And I'm going to fill this tank up, get the results, and we'll take the Infiniti out. Oh yeah, one more thing before we go grab the Infiniti. If you guys are ever in the Lexington area, or you live in the Lexington area and you haven't been here, I highly recommend to visiting this place called Clay's Ferry Outlook, which is where I am now, because you get this view. It's pretty cool. You got a big bridge there, and you get some nature there. It's pretty cool just to come up here and chill out, look at the scenery. There's a nice little area here for you to, you know, enjoy. But yeah, I thought I'd let you guys know while I was up here that you guys should also come visit. Clay's Ferry Outlook is what it's called once again. Alright, so now it's the Infiniti's turn to go. You know the drill. We're going to take this one on the more efficient route. That means we're going to take the interstate all the way to where we need to go and then calculate the total. So, let's get into it. This is going to be brutal and hot because this has no AC as it is, and the windows are going to be up. So, all for the content though. right, so we've made it to the gas station. I'm gonna go ahead and fill up the tank, and then I will get back to you with the results. And let me tell you, this car without AC and the windows up was in fact very brutal, and I'm glad it's just a mere 30 miles. Thank goodness it wasn't longer than that. I think I would have passed out if it was any longer than that. Okay, so just got done filling up at the gas station. Decided to come back here to give you the results where it was quieter. And oh wow, this is a nice car coming up. Look at this. Cool. Anyways, back to what I was saying. I'm here to give you the results, and they're bad. I don't know what happened. It's baffling to me, but in this car, trying to hypermile, I got worse MPG than I usually do on a tank. And in the Honda, I got better MPG than I usually do on a tank. I don't know what I did wrong, but it is what it is, honestly. I'm just at a loss for words. But, you know, I guess I can put in the title now, "You Won't Believe What Happens." And you actually won't believe what happens. Anyways, let's get into the real results. So, in second place, with a whopping 13.4 miles to the gallon, it's the Infiniti Q45 taking second place. Wow. Who would have guessed? The 90s luxury car with a V8 that has 220,000 miles on it gets bad MPGs. Who would have guessed? And you wonder why I don't make this my daily driver. But before I tell you first place, go in the comments and tell me how much you think the Honda beat it by. Anyways, now that you've done that, let's get into the Honda. Taking first place is obviously the Honda CRZ with a whopping 35 miles to the gallon. I don't know what happened, guys. I usually average 16.9 in this, and I usually average like 33.8 in the Honda. I mean, if you can't tell, guys, I really am speechless about this. I really am. You saw the hyperlapses. You know what the deal is. Oh, gosh. Cool story, bro. We all love your truck. Believe me, we do. Anyways, we're going to rerun this test one day, probably over a longer distance. This was a distance of like 30 miles or something. It was a nice day, so I thought, hey, why don't we take both the cars out for a short little drive and be somewhat productive while we do. But yeah, we're definitely rerunning this. I want to see if I can't get those numbers up and down. And until then, this is the video you get. So yeah, if you guys liked it, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe. I know that button likes to light up now when you say subscribe. So I'm more than happy to say that just because I like watching it light up in my own videos. You know, I actually haven't done that yet, but I'll do it on this video. Anyways, that's besides the point. Like and subscribe for more content. I'm trying to actually upload on a regular schedule now, if you can't see. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. We're going to rerun it one day. See ya!